Thanks for tuning in. Today we're going to be reviewing the Snaptain E20 2.7K camera drone. When it comes to affordable and beginner-friendly drones, there are a lot of models and brands to choose from these days. In this review, we're going to be looking at the Snaptain E20, which is one of the latest drones and designed for affordability and ease of use. Here's the packaging. You can see very compact, nice small box. You have a nice graphic of the actual drone printed directly on there. Basic specs and a little illustration of the remote on the side. Again, more specs on the back side and then the other side as well. Go ahead and take it out of the box and we'll go over the specs. So retail price on this is $199.99, but it is available for sale, at least right now, for about $150. This has a 2.7K camera with a 90-degree field of view with a wide-angle design, so you should be able to capture really nice photos and video. It has an 18-minute flight time, and it includes two 2,000 milliamp removable batteries. It also has optical flow positioning, but no GPS. You have an adjustable camera angle using the remote, so you can actually adjust the angle upward or downward. And it does have a couple autonomous flight options, such as a orbit mode, stunts, as well as trajectory mode using the app. In terms of what comes with it, you can see really nice packaging. You have this nice fabric carrying bag with the Snaptain logo on there, and everything really well organized on the inside. So you can see we have the drone itself with a little plastic or paper covers to hold them in place. So you pop that off. It's a foldable design as well, so very compact. You have the remote, and what's cool about the remote, it actually has this little guide that goes right above it, so a little paper guide on top that tells you all the functionality. So you don't even have to look at the manual. You have little rubber spacers to prevent anything from being damaged. You have some propeller guards, so you can use this to prevent this from damaging anything, especially when you're first learning the drone. You have the two batteries, so really nice that they come with two batteries. And they give you a lot more flight time, so you can charge one while using the other. And they actually are USB Type-C rechargeable, which is really nice to see. You have a strap here that's used for the bag itself, so you can actually hold it if you connect the strap through there. Then we also have some accessories in the top pocket. So it looks like we have some replacement blades in here, and they're actually labeled by the type. So each blade is a little bit different, so one side is different from the other, and then you have replacements for each. So you can see two of them in here, as well as some bolts as well. Then you have the charging cable. So again, USB Type-C, which is nice to see. So a nice modern device. So you don't have to rummage for an older style cable. You have the instruction manual and a quick guide here as well, so you can get started pretty quickly. Now let's take a look at the weight of the drone. So the drone with the battery installed, that comes in at 289, and this is actually on purpose. They have to keep this under half a pound to make sure it's classified as a toy and not a professional drone. The remote, it has a replaceable battery on the inside that you can actually just charge up using USB Type-C. That comes in at almost the same weight, 175. The Snaptain E20 is a brand's mid-level beginner-friendly drone that combines higher-end features with a budget price point. The compact folding drone design, so you can see very small, very easy to travel with, and you can see you have folding legs on each side. So most of the bulk is the primary body. To avoid flight restrictions, it's very compact in both dimensions and weight, with a plastic construction as well. You can see you have a traditional quadcopter setup, so if I unfold the legs, you have to make sure you fold the ones with the longer ones first, and then move the outer ones. You can see it's very compact, and with a quadcopter design, two of the blades setups are going clockwise and the other ones are going counterclockwise, so it's very stable and easy to fly with. You can see the body itself has a plastic construction with this gray finish. You have a power button on top, basic branding, Snaptain printed here. And then you can see you have colors on the front. So you have two LEDs, so blue LEDs on the front, and they're almost like eyes as they're two separate LEDs. And then on the rear, you have a wider single one that is green. So pretty compact, and the only real color on here, except for the LEDs, are the blue tips on the propellers themselves. These are brushed motors, so it's not a brushless setup, and it's a non-GPS design, so it really relies on your phone's Wi-Fi as far as the flying control, so you are limited by distance and speed. This does have a 2.7K camera on here, which is really nice. So you can see it's mounted on the front, and you can see the angle is adjustable, and it is motorized, so you can control it on the remote, but it is not a gimbal design. So when you're flying, all those vibrations and movements will translate directly to the video, so you won't get that super smooth video that you're used to with a lot of higher end drones, and that's one reason why this has a more budget price. Also, don't forget to take off the little plastic cover here. It's a little red tab here, so I've already removed it. And a lot of people will forget to leave that on there and then get poor image or video quality. The cool thing about this, though, it is motorized, so you can adjust the angle using the remote, which is a nice feature. On lower end drones, you usually have to hand adjust this. Well, this one, you can actually adjust it mid-flight. As far as batteries, you can see this just uses a removable design. So standard slot design, 2000 milliamps, and you have to actually remove it to charge it, which is unfortunate, because the charging port is actually way over here. It's a USB Type-C, which is nice, and you get two batteries, so if you do run low, you can swap them, and it charges in about 30 minutes, so theoretically, you can just keep flying, charge the next one, and then go back and keep flying. So pretty nice setup. As far as the remote, you can see simple plastic construction, and again, folding design to keep it really compact. So you have the handles on the bottom that actually rotate out. And it's a ratcheting design, so you can see we have the 90 degree angle. You can go wider, and then go even wider than that. So pretty simple setup, and it is fairly ergonomic, even though it's just flat. You also have a cell phone holder, so if I pull that up, you can see I can actually put a cell phone here. It does feel fairly cheap, though. It's just spring-loaded, and the contact location is fairly thin, and that's why there's actually a warning here to take off your phone case if you have a thicker one, as this may not grip it. On the back side, you also have these little slots here, these two rods. So if we pull up, you can actually rotate these downward. And these are just little stands. So you can actually rest this on the ground. And you can see these will actually prop it up. So kind of a cool setup. It almost looks like antennas, but it's just a little bit of a stand, which is a cool design. It is all plastic, though. So you can see pretty simple design with two joysticks. So spring-loaded. This one controls up, down, left, right. This one will control the orientation of the drone. And you also have that nice little cheat sheet that goes right on top of this. You have a couple of buttons here, so landing and then the launching, so you can do that automated. You have speed settings, so you can run lower speed when you're first learning and then turn it up for more responsiveness. You have the power button here, which actually doesn't have any color to it, which is a little bit weird. Would have been nice if it was a red coloring. You have an emergency stop, we'll just kill it and make it free fall. So if you end up about to crash or something, you can hit that and make it sure it just lands. You have a stunt button here, so you can actually do 360 flips. You press that and then rotate the joystick and you can do side, forward, or backward flips. You also have an orbit mode, so this does have some autonomous flight mode, so this will actually rotate around you, which is a nice feature. And then on the backside, you have all the camera control, so you can see two of these spring-loaded dials, so kind of cool design. You can zoom, and then you can also do the angle of the camera, so you can hold it forward or backward, and the motorized camera control will rotate. You also have a button for starting and stopping video capture and taking photos. It's a pretty simple setup. One weird thing about the remote is that it is USB Type-C chargeable, and it does have a little removable slot here if you want to take the battery out, but they don't provide a replacement. So you just have to charge this one, you don't have a second one. When you're done with it, you can see, very compact. You can fold these back over. It does feel cheap though. As I said, the Snaptain logo almost feels like it's tacked on, so I imagine this is shared with other brands, and they just swap out this little piece here. Now let's take the drone out and do some flying. Launching the drone is really easy with the auto launch feature. So you just hold it down and it goes up and then it'll hover in place. You can also do that to land. So you just position near the ground, hold that, and then it'll bring it down gently. Controlling the drone is pretty easy. You have a nice quadcopter design and then two joysticks. So the left joystick is altitude. Up and down will take it upward and downward. Then you can push it left or right, and you can see it'll rotate it clockwise or counterclockwise. The colors on the drone really help you orientate yourself. You also need the live feed from the camera, which again really helps you understand the position of the drone relative to yourself. The right joystick allows you to do pitch and yaw, so that'll actually pitch it forward, backward, or left and right. And you can see using these two joysticks together allows you to do really sharp corners or go around obstacles. As you become better at flying the drone, it becomes easier. Initially, it's a little bit confusing how to control it, but once you get used to that and then you really use the camera image and the combination of the drone controls, you can do nice tight maneuvers. This is a simple quadcopter design, so it is very stable, but in any type of wind, it does kind of blow away, so you do have to be careful with that. The camera quality here is actually pretty nice. It's 2.7K, and you can see you can adjust the camera angle on the fly, and that's a really cool feature. It's motorized. So if you want to adjust your camera angle, you can just press that rear dial and then adjust it. And normally on cheap drones, that is a mechanical position. You have to bring it all the way down and adjust it. But this one, you can actually adjust it mid-flight. You can also do zooming in and out, and you can see it just affects the app. The actual raw image from the memory card on the top right, you can see does not change. Again, another cool feature you don't typically see. Now, the big drawback to these kind of beginner drones is the lack of image stabilization. So you can see in that raw camera image, it is pretty jittery. So there is no image stabilization. There's no gimbal. It is hard mounted to the drone. So every time you do any movement or there's any type of wind, it's directly translated to the image. Unlike a GoPro, there is no electronic image stabilization either. So if you really want to get smooth cinematic images, this is not the drone for that. Instead, it's more of a backyard drone that's really fun to fly. And you can see the image is easy to use, but it is jittery. So if you want to do first person flight, you have to be careful with that as well. The drone itself is pretty easy to fly. You have different speed modes, so you can turn the speed up and down, and that makes it more or less responsive. As you get better at using the drone, you'll want to turn it up to level 2 or 3. You also have some other cool modes like the stunt mode. So you can see there's that button I press there. And then if I hover in place and then press the right joystick, I'll do a side flip or a forward or backward flip, depending on which orientation you push the joystick. It's kind of a cool feature. And this drone also has some other autonomous type features. So you have the orbit mode. So you can see if you press that, it'll start spinning around a fixed radius. It's kind of a cool feature. It is a little bit confusing because it doesn't really spin around a fixed position. It's just where I was looking at the time. But it is a nice autonomous mode that you don't really see with cheaper drones. Aside from that, the drone is pretty easy to use, so you can see you can fly it around tight corners, and then you get a pretty decent image quality, especially if you use a memory card, so then you can extract that and use it for panning shots or any other thing you need. Again, this is a small and lightweight drone, so I don't recommend flying it very high, fast, or far away, as it's very easy to lose. It is limited by Wi-Fi distance. There is no GPS here. So if you go too far away, you will lose connection, and it will just float off, so you do have to be careful with that. And again, it is lightweight, so if you have any type of wind, which is especially common as you go higher up, it will drift away, so you have to be careful. It's more of a backyard drone, really fun to fly, but not as technologically advanced as the higher-end drone, which is why it's a little bit more budget-oriented. With this one, you get a nice autonomous mode, a better camera, and a pretty easy-to-use control setup, so it's a nice the best of both worlds without being too expensive. Now let's take a look at the Snaptain app. This app is specifically designed for the E20 and E10 drones, and as you can see, you can pick between them. It's a couple options here. You have the basic contact us, which gives you the contact information. Tutorial mode shows you a little bit of video. The user manual, which is shown here electronically with a nice PDF, so you can actually scan through it. You also have a couple other options. So you can see here the other. This gives you additional features like flipping the screen, or the novice mode, which shows you all the controls on the joystick. The most important one is the function display, which is not a particularly obvious button, but once you press that, you can see you get the image directly shown on here and a bunch of buttons on top. Pretty much duplicates all the other controls on the actual remote. So you have the speed control, starting, stopping, recording, taking an image. You can do the landings, merge and stop, and everything. So it's a pretty nice setup, and you can see you have all the icons on top. They're not particularly obvious, so some of them you have to kind of try out and see what they are. You can also view all the images that are actually stored on the drone. The background of the drone is initially this ski photo, which is a little bit weird, but you can see it'll quickly be replaced with the actual camera image. You can, again, do some basic initiation of recordings and photos. You can pretty much use the app in place of the drone, and you can see some of the other features like the stopping and landing. have a confirmation so you won't accidentally press it and fall out of the sky. You can also see the app battery and a remaining space on your card if you have it installed on the drone, which is a nice feature. That's the only way to see the battery status, and once the battery status get low, it's really hard to fly the drone. Essentially, it just falls out of the sky, so you have to be careful with that. The other cool thing about this app, it lets you do some more features like autonomous flying. So if you turn off the remote and then enable the controls on the screen, you can see now I can control the drone directly. Now I can press that trajectory button and I can hand draw a trajectory. This will keep the altitude and then match that orientation. So if you draw a vertical line, it'll go forward, backward. Draw left or right, it'll go side to side. It's kind of a cool feature. It doesn't do object tracking like other drones, but it does let you capture some unique photos. So you can get some panning shots or different features such as that. And once you understand the flow, the fact that you actually have to turn off the remote, enable the control, and then press the other button, it's kind of a cool feature, and you can even change the scale so you can do more drastic motions. You can also, again, use this app directly instead of the remote. So you can re-enable just the two joysticks, and then you can fly it around as if you had two virtual joysticks. It's not as easy as actually flying with the real remote, as you don't have the spring-loaded. There's really no haptic feedback, but it is a nice way to fly with it in lieu of the remote. You can also do the full landing here, including the remote, the emergency stop, and the normal landing. Now let's go over the pros and cons of the Snaptain E20. What we like about it is you have a nice premium carrying case. It's a fabric design and it stores the spare batteries and parts all in one place, so it's a great way to travel or store the drone. It's also easy to fly with responsive controls and that classic quadcopter design. The nice thing about this drone is you also have a nice camera. It's a 2.7K camera with good clarity, so you can actually capture details. The main negatives for this drone is the fact that it does lack image stabilization. There is no gimbal on the camera and there is no electronic stabilization, so it is a little bit jittery to watch. The app is also a bit confusing with the autonomous trajectory mode, so you really have to play around with it to understand the different icons. And also at $200, we're a little bit surprised there's no GPS positioning, which also means you have no return to home features. Taking everything into account, we'd give the drone an 8.9 out of 10. It's a nice premium beginner drone with a high quality camera on it. Thanks for watching this review. Don't forget to like and subscribe. You can see more content from us on our website at thesweetcyclist.com, as well as follow us on Instagram at thesweetcyclists. This is The Sweet Cyclist reminding you to enjoy the ride.